we have a complete data set in China from 1077 showing the commercial tax quotas, 3% transit tax, 3% sales tax, for all of China, 4,000 tax stations, right? And we have it, in fact, for 2 years, two comparative years, 1077, I guess 1058 or something like that. And so I said, well, let's see what we find out. Since we have towns in the CHGS database as well, let's see what we find out if we start to look at the commercial tax system on a map. And what we find is this. We find that, in fact, and there's a very important story here. If the red are prefectural seats with tax quotas, all the circles, by the way, have the same value, the size is the same value. The yellow are counties, but the black are towns, market towns. And what we see in this map is one of the most important stories in Chinese economic history. We're looking at the moment when the economic hierarchy, the economic network, and the administrative network diverged. This happens during the first great commercial revolution in Chinese history. The money supply increases by 30 times over what it was in the ninth century. This is in 1077. And what we see is that there are counties that have more tax than their prefectural seats, or their prefectures they belong to, and towns that pay more tax than the counties they belong to. So the administrative hierarchy, which in the 8th century was also the economic hierarchy, has now diverged from the economic hierarchy. There are separate things going on, separate networks. They overlap a great deal, but they're separate. And that's what happens when private interests and private wealth are able to vie with the state and state power.